ordinary day for Carolyn Bigsby. She had planned to bake her husband a strudel, give her dog a bath, and water her African violets. Yes, Carolyn had planned to do all sorts of things, she thought, now. But earlier that day, a woman who wasn't her friend told Carolyn something she wasn't supposed to hear. From that moment on, Carolyn felt nothing really mattered anymore.
Carol, what are you doing?
I've been thinking, Harpy, that if you love this Monique woman so much, maybe you should be with her.
For God's sake, Carolyn, she's dead.
Yeah, I
know. Oh!
Carolyn Bigsby had planned on it being an ordinary day.
Come out of there, damn it!
But as every housewife knows,
nobody goes anywhere.
Plans change.
I'm sure some of you might be thinking that this is all my fault. I'm the bad guy here, but I'm not. He is. Will you people stop calling me? I'm right in the middle of something. He humiliated me. First, he cheated on me with a stewardess named Monique. How cliche is that? And then he told people about it. Now there are news trucks out there. Judy Pope's husband has an affair. Nobody finds out. Mine cheats. They break into programming. I told you to stop calling me. I'm sorry. I got something else. Oh my God, is that today? I'm so sorry. Hey, what did I say?
I'm sorry, we'll be quiet. You and your friend are really starting to bug me. She's not my friend.
We are sharing custody and she tried to seduce my husband, so
she put the moves on your husband? Why didn't you say so?
Look at me that way, you know you wanted her dead.
How can you say that?
Well, you told me about her and your husband after I made it pretty clear where I stand on divorce.
I did not want this. Don't you dare say that I wanted this.
Shut up! No, I will not! Shut up! What's the matter with you?
Have you not been paying attention? My husband cheated on me.
Who cares? Who cares? We all have pain. Everyone in here has pain, but we deal with it. We swallow it.